All right, what's up, guys? I'm going to take the lead on this one. So this is David West, and we're touching down here in Hong Kong now. So as you can see, this is a nice little view of the cityscape there with all the different lights there on the waterline and shoreline. Kind of looks like a New York City type deal. There you can see Apple and some more of the cityscape. That was definitely one of the highlights of the trip that we got to see, was just how big Hong Kong actually was. Just a little fun fact is Hong Kong has the most skyscrapers per city in the world, with New York City as a second. As you see there's some really cool statues and nice culture within Hong Kong with all the flashing lights in the city. There we have the longest escalator in the world, which we actually got a ride on. This is part of the subway system that Hong Kong has. They actually have one of the best subway systems in the entire world. This is Modern Terminals, where we got to meet with one of the top executives who is actually from the States, from our local hometown. But this is just shows how big Modern Terminals it actually is and how big the operations are. They ship tons of these freights every single day. So as you can see here, this is kind of part of our self-exploration day, where we got to go up and see a Buddha temple, see some of the nice rural parts of China, whereas we were seeing lots of the cityscape now. As you can see, they're very beautiful temples. People really enjoy the culture here. This is just a nice little park where everyone can sit down, relax, see a nice view, catch a game of checkers, and even swing on swings.
The second city we visited is Zhuhai, China. Zhuhai's population is today over 1.6 million people, with many of its highly educated and talented citizens coming from different regions of China. Zhuhai is located at the southern part of Guangdong province, and in 1999, Zhuhai was honored as the International Award for Most Improving Living Environment by the United Nations. Our first visit was to Gri Electric. Gri Electric gave us the understanding of how advanced China is in technology compared to the other countries. Gri Electric had introduced concept in research and development, manufacturing, marketing, and services. Then the employees had introduced us to a wide product range of air conditioners, air source water heaters, and also smartphones. Our second trip was to our sister's school in Zhuhai. It was interesting to see the school and meet the students at Bryant Zhuhai campus. I personally enjoyed talking to Wuhan, a student who took my group and I to a campus tour and ate dinner together. Wuhan taught me personally how does the Chinese culture looks like, and also how is it different studying at Bryant Zhuhai. Visiting a trade zone showed us that China is trying to develop a business system in the upcoming years. It showed us the most beautiful buildings of development plan for the Hangzhou area. After that, we visited a hotel in Zhuhai. This hotel reminds me of Atlantis Hotel in Dubai. The hotel was large, beautiful, and very attractive to many people. The hotel had dolphins and flamingos while visiting the grounds. This hotel will definitely expand out further and become well known with high revenues in the upcoming years. As you can see, we had a dialogue with the Deputy Director of Commercial Affairs, and this was definitely a lifetime experience. The information we shared during the panel discussion had been an eye-open trip for us, giving us a deep insights into the foreign investments in China. One of my favorite parts is when Dana had taught me the art of bargaining in China, which is relatively similar to how you bargain in Saudi Arabia, but I totally enjoyed it practicing it in Mandarin. As you can see, Dana got really mad at the seller because he did not give her a good price for her microphone. At the end of the day, we as an MBA students went to a karaoke to experience a Chinese culture activity.
Here, we come to the third largest city of China, the city named Guangzhou. Guangzhou is one of the biggest trading cities in China, plus it is the major port and transportation of Silk Road. In Guangzhou, we visit the company named Getty. with the full name is Guangdong Electric Power Design Institute. This company has many projects for an energy saving. They are trying to innovate the power system to produce more electric with less resources. Their projects are all over the world, especially in Southeast Asia, for example, Vietnam and Cambodia. However, most of their products never reached the US. As you can see, Gandhi have many sponsors who are trying to innovate the green power together with the company. Then, we visit the Yugechi Foreigner Language School. This school is located in the central of Guangzhou. This school also shows us how an environment of high school in China is. Even they have a limited space, they still try to encourage students to do outside activity, for example, soccer and badminton. At the end of the day, we get to experience mini care service and shopping at the knockoff market.
Today, we arrived to Shenzhen and visited Das Intellitech company. The company provides energy saving service to buildings. The company operates its business primarily through the consulting service. One of the staff were showing us different type of the security lockers and explained to us how it works. Roma also tested their new entrance equipment. What took our attention is how a tablet controls everything, such as lighting. The company also provides new innovative equipment to the hospitals and cinemas. Folk Village. I always want to show people around me where I came from. And today, my dream came true. Xinjiang, the northwest of China. The people there are called Uyghur and they are one of the Turkic ethnic group. Looking at my Brian crew dancing for Uyghur song, I felt in touch. Hin and Julio were dancing like professional dancers. I would like to say the Folk Village became my favorite place of the trip. This is a traditional Uyghur house with all different cultural furnitures. Nowadays, there is no longer place like this in Xinjiang. This is Chinese famous opera called Jingju. If you come to China, you must need to listen to this. It covers all history and all kind of stories in it. We also walked by street restaurant that we always wanted to go. We also came to Mini Tibet, which is famous Mount Everest located. Here is lighting night view of the park. At night, we watched a live show. The performance amazed us. The kids are so flexible to do the gymnastics. What was surprised us is the animals. They were brought on the stage and the little goat in the end made our day.
All right, so now we're gonna get into some of the food. Being an American, this was definitely an experience. Nothing like the Chinese American food we have now, especially those breakfast nuggets that we gotta have at the hotels. As you can see here, there's some like dogs and cats being fried up on a grill. Wasn't really sure what we were eating the whole time, but I made a point not to ask. As you can see here, they're definitely prepping their food, and we had to try, of course, the most American place you can go, KFC.
That's my favorite.
And as you can see now, Julio was trying to order some food, no idea what it is. But one of the things that we really noticed was the Lazy Susans that they have, that you can just pass around food easily. Look at all this delicious food. Don't really know what it is, but it was amazing. Especially the fish. The vegetables, just the way that they presented and prepared the food was amazing. Look at us just taking pictures of how well it was presented and prepared. And there you can see us just all fighting over food, trying to get some of the pancakes that they had there. And this is the food that they grilled for us right up. Look at that ugly bastard. Oh man. But he was great. He tasted delicious. Oh. So now we're kind of ending off with our meal there with a nice little traditional song and dance that the host there perform for us. Definitely a nice vibe, a nice culture.
And as we can see that we have a lot of buffet. And this is how to end this. We need to say bye to the food.
Thanks for saying
good. Bye-bye.
Rising and when I get that feeling, I won't set you free.